Hello, good afternoon. And SEBI's changes in LODR regulations on verification of rumors, rumor verification. One would recall that this was a big theme last year, around this time, almost around this time, because it was in June 2023 that the provisions of LODR were amended on various matters. Regulation 23 amendments were done, which included the responses to market rumors as well. And this was a huge commotion issue among larger companies, and companies were concerned as to how would this be implemented, etc. As SEBI had taken the task of taking it to some level of discussion. There was a consultation paper, there were discussions in meetings called by the stock exchanges. The matter was eventually taken to the SEBI's board meeting and amendments were done. So on the 17th of May, amendments in LODR regulation, the regulatory amendments have already been done. They've already been notified a few days back. However, the actual implementation may still have to wait for a while because the framework for computing the so-called material price movement, which is the critical piece for the rumor to be of any relevance at all, that's yet to come. That would probably come very shortly. We're expecting that to come anytime now. And again, when that framework for computing or assessing the material price movement come, there'll be further details to be talked about. But in the meantime, we go ahead with this small video presentation on what exactly is the change on rumor verification for larger companies. So what exactly are we talking about? We're talking about changes in Regulation 30 by 11, insertion of a new Regulation 11A in LODR regulations, done effective 17th of May. And the history of these changes is that the original change was done, like I said, almost a year back, June 14, 2023, mandating larger companies, top 100 or top 250 companies, to mandatorily respond to market rumors. There were chinks, there were issues there, and that's why the discussion process, etc. The original implementation date for the change was October 1, 2023, later on extended twice, first to Feb 1 and thereafter to June 1, 1st of June 2024 for the top 100 companies. For top 250 companies, originally August 1st 2024 and later on 1st December 2024. As it stands, these dates are still the same. However, given the fact that the material price movement framework I was talking about is still not ready, it is quite likely that the dates may be deferred. That's something that we'll get to know soon. Like I said, there will be an occasion to come back on this topic. But as of now, we go ahead and try and understand what are the changes. So once again, who is impacted? The top 100 or top 250 companies, depending on the timeline that you're talking about, by market capitalization. Rest of the companies, the framework still remains voluntary. However, because now there's a framework which relates the rumors to material price movement, I would imagine that even if smaller companies which voluntarily may or may not respond to market rumors, they might also relate it to the framework for so-called material price movement. So all this while we were talking about MPM, and during this presentation I'll talk about this MPM several times. What exactly is the so-called material price? I'll come to what exactly does the material price movement mean in a minute from now. But let's understand what exactly are companies required to do if there is a material price movement. Assuming there is an MPM, there's a material price movement, then we try correlating the MPM with a rumor in mainstream media. Once again, this word, what exactly is mainstream media? There would probably be hundreds of thousands of publications all over. Which one of these constitutes mainstream media? The word is extremely wide in import, and therefore there might be thousands of publications which constitute the so-called mainstream media. Therefore, the company will still have to scout around searching for the information. But nevertheless, in the age of technology, if there is a rumor about the company which has caused an impact on prices, it's unlikely that the company would not be able to track it. Shareholders have reacted to a rumor. That would mean the rumor is widely read. The rumor would have been seen by the market. If the market could see it and express the reaction to the rumor, for the company to say that I am not even aware of what rumor is circulating would be completely unacceptable. Because obviously, we're talking about the rumor having its impact, having its reach on the shareholders. So there are two things we're talking about. Number one, the beginning of the entire exercises, is there a material price movement? No matter what rumors or what publications are being made about the company, if there is no material price movement, there's nothing for us to do. So the starting point of the exercise is material price movement. The material price movement correlates with a rumor in mainstream media. The moment we say that the material price movement is connected with the rumor, we're basically saying the rumor has been spread before the so-called MPM, because we're expecting the rumor to have caused the MPM. That would mean the MPM might have happened first and the rumor came thereafter. It probably would have no impact at all, because we're talking about the rumor impacting or the rumor resulting into. The nexus between the two is the key to the entire exercise. So there is a means material price movement. The material price movement is connected with or has a nexus with mainstream media rumors. Rumor is about some definitive event or information. I would like to stress on the word definitive. Purely generic event or information. Event or information which is generic in nature. For example, let's say one is talking about the industry, one is talking about the sector, one is talking about the country's economy, one is talking about, let's say, the climate risk, the weather. Things which are purely generic, which are not company specific. It's not talking about some event or information about the company, then we are not covered by this requirement. We're covered by the requirement only when there is an event or information specifically pertaining to the company, and this is definitive, pure conjectures, pure imaginative stuff. Once again, wouldn't require us to respond, but there is a rumor about some event or information which is impending. That would mean it's about to happen or waiting to be disclosed by the company. That would mean there is something cooking up in the company. Something is cooking up within the company. There is some event or information which, of course, the company is aware of, or the company would do what could be aware of, but the company has so far not disclosed. So basically what I'm saying is the company has not disclosed something, but the market has still got the wind of it. The market has still got some hint, some wind. The market has got some whiff about the event or information. The market has already started reacting. In essence, what we're talking about? We're talking about an information asymmetry. Disclosure of information by the company, including response to rumors, is all about ensuring symmetrical availability of information. Information has been leaked into the press by someone. That someone could probably be an insider of the company. That's something that we are going to come talk about separately, maybe. But there is something which is cooking up within the company. There's an event or information that the company is aware of, or could have been aware of. The company has so far not gone and disclosed it. But in the meantime, someone has created a rumor on that information. The rumor may either be, correctly representing the event or information. The rumor may be misrepresenting the event or information. The event or information may not be there at all, and the rumor might still be talking about it. So there might be various situations, but there is some event or information about which the rumor is talking about. It's a definitive event or information, and this rumor has already caused a material price movement. If these conditions are, each of these conditions are satisfied, the company shall either confirm the rumor. When the company says yes, there is something, the company shall confirm it. That would mean even if the stage for disclosure has not still come, the company was still waiting to disclose it. But given the fact that the market has already talked about it, this would accelerate the situation, accelerate the requirement for immediate disclosure, because some section of the investors already know about it. The press is talking about it. And therefore, there is a false market, or there is a market already being created. I wouldn't call it false. And therefore, the company should now open its mouth and reveal what is the correct situation. The company shall either confirm or the company shall deny. And if the confirmation or denial is to be based on some further information from a promoter, director, or KMP, or a senior manager, that is about whom the rumor is being spread, the company may seek the information, the same information, from the respective correspondent, and the counterparty shall promptly, accurately, adequately respond to the same. And all of this must be done. The company will then go public and make a disclosure, make the company statement about the so-called rumor, which will be done within 24 hours from the trigger of the NPM. The company's affirmation or denial must be done within 24 hours from the trigger of the MPM. Later, I'll talk about what is the relevance of this 24 hours of trigger of MPM. How serious would this requirement be? I'll talk about that in minutes from now. So once again, very quickly summarizing. A, there is a rumor in mainstream media. The rumor is about some definitive event or information which is specific to the company, not generic in nature. It's definitive as also specific to the company. And this is about some event or information which is impending, which is about to be disclosed, which is, I mean, whether the company would have in general course disclosed or not, that becomes less relevant. As we'll talk about in a minute from now, you'll probably see that whether the event of information would have come under Regulation 30 disclosure or not, that becomes less relevant because the stress is entirely on MPM. I'll maybe talk about that in a minute from now, that the fact that there is an MPM makes it irrelevant for us to get into the question whether the event or information would have been a Regulation 30 event or information or not. That would mean even if the information or event wouldn't in normal course wouldn't have come under Regulation 30, the fact that it has already caused the material price movement proves that the information is price sensitive. Therefore, the so-called significant market reaction, which is the essence of Regulation 30, is already satisfied because we have a proof that there is an MPM already, and therefore significant market reaction has already been caused. So we do not need to get into the question as to whether the event or information would otherwise require disclosure under Regulation 30 or not. We'll talk about this point in a minute from now once again. But let's for a minute quickly try understanding what exactly is material price movement. What I'm going to talk about in the next couple of minutes is still based on the consultation paper. We do not have the final framework, which, like I mentioned, would be expected very soon. But the consultation paper, assuming that the methodology given in consultation paper remains correct, we are talking about three separate, let's say, thresholds. As regards the materiality itself is based on the price of the script. If the price of the script is less than 100, we're talking about 5% change. 100 to 200, we're talking about 4% change. And more than 200, we're talking about 3% change. 3, 4, or 5, movement in the price of the script. The movement in the price of the script could happen any time during the trading day. This is very important. The spike in the price, that is the increase or decrease, the rise or the drop in the price, is to be seen at any point of time during the day, and we compare it with the closing price of the previous trading day. So comparing with the previous closing price, if there is a 5, 4 or 3, depending on the price of the script, percent movement in the price of the script, in that case, we compare it with the general price, and that is the general index movement as well. Now, if the index also on that very trading, then the index also has moved, that would mean the index also shows a movement during the day. In that case, the 5, 4 or 3 will be incremented by the increase or decrease in the index. As long as the index has moved within 1%, that is minus 1 to plus 1% in movement in the index, the 5, 4 and 3 will remain the same. If the movement in the index, that is the index has dropped by more than 1%, or the index has gone up by more than 1%, in that case, the movement in the index will be added to the 5, 4 or 3. For example, the index during the day moved, let's say, dropped by 5%. Assuming the index dropped by 5%, so which means the movement in the index is more than 1%, in that case, the 5, 4 and 3 will become 10, 9 and 8%. That is, the movement in the index will, the intensity of the movement in the index will be added to the 5, 4 or 3% change I was talking about. But the important point to note is that the movement in the price of the script itself is to be taken at any point of time during the day. Price movements during the day, the trigger point therefore may happen any time during the trading hours. Now let's assume that at, let's say, 11 a.m. on a trading day, the script went up by, let's say it went up by 5%, breaching the materiality trigger. 11 a.m. during the day, the material change in the price occurred. That would mean now from 11 a.m. my clock will start ticking because the NPM has happened. And therefore, I'll now have to scout through or search through the mainstream media to say that, to see if there was a rumor about the company. 11 a.m. I start searching for the rumors about the company. It would probably take some time. In the age of technology, probably we're depending on search. So I would search through the mainstream media and see if there is a rumor about the company. Like I mentioned, to say that the rumor was in such inconspicuous source that I couldn't even track it would actually not be acceptable because the rumor has already caused the movement in the price. Assuming that we found a NPM is there, but we are not able to find a rumor in the mainstream media. That's all that was needed. I did my search. There was an NPM, but I was not able to find any rumor in the mainstream media at all. I'll probably have to document it somewhere. I'll probably have to document that I did a search, but I was not able to find any mainstream media rumor at all. In which case, I'll probably do a recording that we couldn't find such a rumor. But normally speaking, if there is a rumor causing the movement in prices, shareholders have already reacted on that. And therefore, the company would not be able to find it, does not seem acceptable. So hopefully, I'll be able to find that particular source which has caused the price trigger. So in that case, I said 11 a.m. we start searching. We're able to find the mainstream media report. Now the company will have to then open its mouth and say, and let's say this mainstream media rumor, the so-called mainstream media rumor, is pertaining to some definitive event or information which is happening within the company is not going to disclose it, either because the company thought that this is not disclosable at all. It's not something which is falling under Regulation 30. Or maybe the company probably would have concluded that it's so far premature for the company to go for disclosure. Non-disclosure of an event or information would be either because the stage for disclosure has not come. The company would want to disclose an event or information at an appropriate stage. The stage when the information becomes certain. That certainty stage has not come. That might be one reason. Or maybe the company might take a view that it's not falling under any of the items of Regulation 30. It's not expected to have a significant market reaction. That was the company's viewpoint earlier. But now the viewpoint is anyway incorrect because the market has already reacted based on the very same information which was leaked out into the mainstream media somewhere. So having now, I said from 11 a.m. we start the searching process. And therefore, we find what event or information was being talked about. We ascertain the facts about the event or information. Maybe the investor relations officer or the compliance officer wasn't aware about the event. We'll probably have to search or seek information from the promoters or maybe from the KMPs or maybe from the SMPs. Ascertain the facts and do a disclosure within 11 a.m. of the next. We got a time frame of 24 hours. 24 hours of the trigger of the NPM, that is from the point of time when the price trigger showed that 5403 threshold, from that point onwards I've got 24 hours to disclose. So I will have to do a disclosure to the exchanges within 24 hours. Try understanding some of situations where we can understand whether this Regulation 30/11 is applicable. So I said the trigger point is NPM. We have understood what NPM actually is. So assuming NPM is yes, material price movement has happened. The material price movement, there was some impending material event or information under Regulation 30. That would mean the company has some event or information which would have required disclosure under Regulation 30. And this information the company has not disclosed. But in the meantime, the market has already been tipped. This is basically a breach of information protocol, because information was to stay confidential, but nevertheless, it's been leaked out. There's a leakage of information. There's a leakage, information leak. So there is a rumor in mainstream media. And therefore, now at this stage, though the company has not disclosed it still, but verification of rumor by the company will be required. The company will be required to immediately go ahead within 24 hours of the NPM trigger. The company will be required to disclose. As per the company, the stage for disclosure has not come because the information is still, let's say, under process. Let's say, for instance, if there's an acquisition proposal, the proposal is not passed through the board approval or whether the due diligence phase at which the company would have gone and disclosed it. But given the fact that the press already knows about it, the company will have to open its mouth. The company might probably say, yes, information is there, but it's still pending affirmation. It's pending some, let's say, some approval, some And there is a pendency. The company will have to therefore reveal the fact that there is an information, but there is a pendency as of now, and therefore the company is not disclosed. But to say that the company would not still give particulars because the stage has not come, that wouldn't be proper anymore, because part of the media already knows it. The information is already in public domain. So at this stage, the company cannot remain. The company cannot maintain a complete silence. The company will have to disclose particulars, which may also include that there are pendencies, there are approvals pending, but the company cannot be completely vague. The company cannot be completely non-transparent because the information has already been leaked. So leakage of the information amounts to preponing the stage of dispute. As per the company, the stage is still not there. But given the fact that there is a leakage, it would now mandate an immediate response from the company because there is asymmetry of information. Let's move to the next situation. Supposing there is a material price movement. Now, important part here is that there is a material price movement. Yes. However, there is no event or information which would have come under Regulation 30. Maybe it was not within the ambit of Regulation 30. Maybe the magnitude was not meeting the test of 2% to 5%, 2% to 5% based on the Regulation 30 disclosure threshold. Or maybe the company did its own computation. The company thought that the information is not likely to cause a significant market reaction. Therefore, as per the company, neither was it a deemed material event, nor was it a material event which is meeting the numerical threshold given in Regulation 30. Therefore, the company wouldn't have cared about disclosing it in terms of Regulation 30. However, there is a rumor and there is a material price movement. This information which the company wasn't wanting to disclose because the thresholds of Regulation 30 are not met has already caused material price movement. So that itself satisfies the condition. The important part is that the company will be required to respond to the rumor now, because the fact that there is a material price movement makes it irrelevant for us to examine whether the information was or was not requiring disclosure in terms of Regulation 30. That is, because the price sensitivity is already proven. In hindsight, we see a price movement already that satisfies the significance of the information. The market has taken it seriously. The company was not taking seriously. The market has taken it seriously already. The market is reflecting that in price movement. And therefore, that would compel an immediate response from the company to disclose the facts about the rumored event or information. Let's move to the next part. Let's say there's a material price movement. There is an impending event of information, the company has not gone and disclosed it still. There is no rumor at all. There's no rumor. Nothing has been. I did a search, however, I wasn't able to. Material price movement was visible. Price movement was visible. However, there's no rumor. Now, as of now, this will not require, there's no rumor to be verified. The company may disclose the event of information on reaching of the appropriate stage. But given the fact that there's a price movement already, it would be important for the company to see, are there some people, are there some insiders or people who are privy to information who have gone and done the trade? The company should do a soul searching to see whether the information integrity, the safety net of the information chain is being kept confidential, the confidentiality is being preserved, and the insiders who are in the know have not gone, because there's no rumor of that. That would mean the information has not gone to a stage of being public. However, the prices have reacted, which means the company might still want to see whether the price movement is anyway pertaining to some leakage or some insider. So this might actually be throwing a signal of insider trading, and therefore the company needs to do its own investigation to see if there is a breach of information protocol, but there is no rumor to be verified or responded to. Similarly, if there's a material price movement, there is no impending event, there's no rumor at all. There's no rumor to be verified at all. There is a material price movement is not there. There is a rumor. However, there is no material price movement. This is also a case where rumor verification is not required because there's no material price movement. However, the company would, because we are saying there is an event or information in terms of Regulation 30, there's a rumor as well. The company will follow the normal principles of Regulation 30 disclosure, that is, disclose the information at an appropriate stage. So, in terms of implementation of this very, very important change, companies which are covered by this requirement. Like I mentioned, top 100 companies will be covered only in few days, unless they extend the dates. Top 250 companies will probably have some more breathing space. But the question is that we need to assess material price movement momentarily. The clock will start ticking the moment there is an MPM. MPM occurs at 11 a.m. If you come to know, let's say at 3 p.m., you already lost 4 hours. So since you cannot afford to lose time, you need to have technology tools in place which will throw a signal the moment there is an MPM. I don't think it's very hard to put those signals in place. I think it might be may just require a simple technology tool which throws an alert to the concerned officer, whether it's the compliance officer or information investor relationship officer. That's for the company to actually fix. But whoever is the concerned officer should get a signal the moment there is MPM. MPM and the correlation of the MPM with the general movement of index. So we'll probably have to create a technology tools which sees the movement in prices, which correlates with the movement in general market index, and sees if the price of the security is breaching the threshold 543. Added to that, the movements in the index as well, assuming the index movements are more than plus one or minus one, we add those changes as well. So the company gets an alert as soon as possible because we can't afford to lose time on that. That's part one. Having got the alert that there is a MPM trigger, then the company will also have to start searching for the rumor. So once again, we are talking about some technology tools which do the searching. Putting people on Google search probably would be too slow a matter, because I don't think any company can afford to dedicate people to do a Google search here. But probably some kind of technology tools to assist in the rumor searching through the mainstream media. And then we ask the question, does this rumor relate to a definitive event or information? It's not generic in nature. It's not about general performance or expected performance of the company, expected prospects of the company. It's about some definitive event. For example, bagging of an order, losing of an order, thinking of some acquisition proposal, going for some expansion, going for some corporate action. So there's a definitive event or action, event or information to which the rumor pertains to. And this is specific to the company. It's not generic in nature. If the answer to each of these is yes, then we go further. And does the rumor relate to an impending event or information? That is some event or information which is developing within the company. It's evolving within the company, developing. But the rumor has already been leaked. In that case, the company will go and do the affirmation or denial of the rumor within 24 hours of what? The MPM trigger. Within 24 hours of the MPM trigger. So in terms of understanding the flow of the process, the whole starting point is MPM trigger. MPM trigger, how to assess based on, it's on daily basis. Momentarily. It's not just daily. Done every day and done every moment when the prices are changing, right? So we find that there is a trigger. Then we search for the rumor. Search where? In the mainstream media. Is the rumor definitive? That is, it relates to the company specifically. It's not generic in nature. Answer is yes. The rumor relates to some impending event or information. That would mean there is a leakage. It's very important for the company to have an internal check on the leakage as well, because leakage of unpublished price sensitive information, oopsie, is a very serious matter. Companies will have to investigate if there was a price leak, I'm sorry, information leak. Who is responsible? Information leaks are very serious, and the responsibility lies right up to the board of directors to ensure that we are maintaining integrity of information. So that's separate part. But in the meantime, the company will have to A, confirm or deny or clarify on the rumor. And this will be done, like I mentioned, within 24 hours of the trigger. So the entire cycle has to be completed within 24 hours. If the rumor is indeed confirmed, then there are some enabling provisions to exclude the fluctuations in prices which occurred from the point of publication of the rumor till the confirmation or denial by the company. Confirmation. If the company actually confirmed the rumor, then the impact on prices which happened from the point of publication of the rumor till the confirmation by the company, that fluctuation, that spike whether the price rise or price drop will be excluded from the computation of the prices of the company required for ICDR or required for SAST or required for buyback regulation. Enabling changes are done in each of these regulations as well to exclude. If the company, however, is not that denies the rumor, then the question of the correlation between the rumor and the price change does not arise. Therefore, the computations for each of these ICDR, buyback, or SAST will go as usual. Will this change in regulation require us to do any changes in policy? Probably policy changes may not be needed, but if companies have SOPs which are drawn as the policies, then the SOPs may need to be fine-tuned, because now we're talking about 24 hours, we're talking about how would the action go, who is responsible for the action, where all do we search, etc., etc. So SOPs may have to be defined by larger companies. More importantly, we'll have to throw the responsibility. Companies will have to define responsibility. Who is responsible? Who will do this? Alerts are thrown. Alerts will go to who? And then who will do the mainstream media search? And who will verify or ascertain facts about the information? Who will seek the information from KMPs, etc.? So responsibility centers will have to be defined. So this is very important. From perspective of actual implementation, companies have to do a searching through, fix up responsibilities and search for, prepare for the answer to be given within 24 hours. Serious issue, serious topic. I would not want to leave it serious. Therefore, this is a najam by Urdu najam, which was made quite popular by Jagdeep Singh. Jagdeep Singh sang this najam. So I've done some tweaking of the words of the najam to relate it to a rumor verification. And I'm just reading it out just to make it a little lighter ending. Baat niklegi to phir dur ta lag jayegi. Rumor is basically what? Baat nikal rahi. Company se ko baat nikli hai. Baat niklegi to phir dur ta lag jayegi. Exchange bevajah chuppi ka sabab poochenge. Ye bhi poochenge ki tum pareshan kyun ho? Jagmagate huye lammo mein gurejan kyun ho? Ungliyan uthegi kaampte huye share ki taraf. Share price ki taraf. उंगलियां उठेगी कांपते हुए शेयर की तरफ, कंपनी में चलते किसी अफेयर की तरफ, बीओडी पर भी कई तंज किए जाएंगे, कांपते सीएस पे भी फिक्रे कटे जाएंगे, चुप्पी न रखना दिल की बात लबों पे लाना, चुप्पी न रखना दिल की बात लबों पे लाना, वरना अफवाह का मजा लेगा जमाना, और बात निकलेगी तो फिर दूर तलक जाएगी. थैंक यू वेरी मच. विल कम बैक सून as the framework for implementation comes from either Exchange or SEBI, expected very soon. So we'll probably have to be connecting back on this. But in the meantime, do be ready for rumor verification. Thanks a ton for listening and keep watching our videos. Thanks.